Hello, my name is Clint Hudson, and I am the manager of DEM applications for Applied DEM, introducing a video series on how our product, Bulk Flow Analyst, can help with the design of feeders, hoppers, and silos. Feeder, hopper, and silo design can be very challenging. There are a lot of goals that must be met simultaneously for well-functioning operation of such systems. Today, we're going to look at forces on the feeder belt at the feeder outlet. We'll show how to obtain these results with DEM and compare them with some analytical results. We'll also see that we can obtain these results despite some unconventional geometry. In later videos, we'll focus on other aspects of feeder and hopper design. Keep your eyes open for more videos to come. The first step in performing such a simulation is in your material characterization. Without accurate material characteristics, your results will always be suspect. So, step one is to perform the material characterization simulations, now available on the DEM cloud. The next step is to prepare the model to record the forces for the important components using the stress precision index property. To improve performance for your simulations, this property has a value of 1 by default. A value of 1 means that the forces will not be recorded for the faces of your components. Setting this to a value greater than 1 records forces, and the higher values offer more precise stress results because the software more precisely records the locations where forces are applied. For our example, we're examining forces only, not stresses, so any value greater than 1 will do. If you want to examine the forces on the belt when the feeder starts, you must create two belts, one that is stationary and one that is moving. We will set the timing of these two belts in such a way that the stationary one is replaced by the moving belt. Set up the rest of the components in your simulation as necessary and run the simulation. Once the simulation is complete, we can get access to the forces. Finding belt forces analytically is challenging. Analytical solutions generally support bins and hoppers with simple, symmetric shapes and free-flowing materials. In addition, there are several analytical solutions to choose from, and results vary widely when applied to a given application. For my example today, I have a bin with a rectangular cross-section flowing into a hopper with sloping sides, while the front and rear are vertical. This is a simple example. Later in the video, we'll examine some changes that somewhat complicate the geometry and make analytical approaches more difficult. To access the belt forces, we will use Force Analyst. Force Analyst will allow users to measure forces on individual faces of the belt, but since we're looking at the belt as a whole, and in fact we're examining two belts at the same time, we have to select all of the faces for both belts. This just takes a moment to select them, like so. Force Analyst also gives us the ability to show normal or shear forces, as well as forces along a user-defined vector. We're going to choose this option. We're going to make sure that our vector is in the y direction, positive y direction. We're going to add this series to be graphed, and we're going to select plot. After a few minutes, the plot is complete, and it looks like this. You can see that the shear forces build in the negative direction, that is, in the direction of the belt, for a time from 0 to about 10 seconds, when it plateaus as the bin stops filling. At 15 seconds, the belt begins to move, and the shear forces hit a positive peak, and then begin to settle down into the somewhat steady state condition as the belt is moving. One might ask, why is there a negative shear force during the filling portion of the simulation? This can be explained as the static shear force necessary to prevent the particles from flowing out through the feeder opening, even though the belt isn't moving. In this graph, we're not only showing the shear forces generated by Bulk Flow Analyst, but we're also showing the normal forces on the belt as generated by Bulk Flow Analyst. The orange curve is a calculated result based on the normal forces measured by Bulk Flow Analyst and a formula generated by Dr. Alan Roberts. This orange curve does not represent the actual shear forces on the belt, but instead is a measurement of the shear forces necessary to cause the particles to shear and flow from the bin. It can easily be seen that during the flow portion of the simulation, the measured shear force from Bulk Flow Analyst is in very close agreement with the formulas developed by Dr. Roberts. So one might ask, why go to all this trouble when you can obtain these results analytically? Well, there are situations where the analytical results are less reliable, and most of those have to do with unusual geometries. So in this slide, you can see that we've developed three different versions of this feeder hopper combination. There's one without any inserts, we've got one with these transverse inserts, and we've got one with a longitudinal insert. You can see that the results of the flow pattern are slightly different for each one of these. Using different inserts, we can achieve lower initial torques, as shown in this example. This is the graph that I showed you just a few moments ago. This one is one with inserts, this is one without. Now if you compare all three of these, you'll find that the highest spike comes from the one, the example with no inserts. The next highest uses the longitudinal insert, and coming in a close third is the transverse inserts model. But you can also see that the steady state running condition, or the flow condition, generates three very different shear forces. The longitudinal insert provides the lowest shear force of the three. Thank you for watching this video on feeders and hoppers. I hope that it was a good use of your time. Please click subscribe below to be notified when we release other videos. Visit the Applied DEM website on Facebook, or connect with us, Applied DEM, on LinkedIn. Next week, we'll see how Bulk Flow Analyst can be used to examine flow patterns within a silo. Again, click subscribe to be notified when this video is available. Thanks again. Bye.